Welcome back. Stasa 23 here, back again with some knife therapy. And today, I'm going to go over a question that's asked to me pretty often. I'm going to give you five folders that are in the $40 to $50 price range that, in my eyes, are the best bang for your buck. And best bang for your buck, we'll start with a buck. This is the Buck Vantage Pro and S30V with the Paul Ball Seat Treat. I think that's $347, made in the USA. And it's got G10 overlays with some plastic rivery right here with some stainless liners. There you go, Paul Ball Seat Treat. Some of the best in the business. Now, this knife comes in right at $54. So S30V with the Paul Ball Seat Treat is a steal. Nice and ergonomic. It would make a great work knife, decently thin behind the edge. Now, I will say they had tons of quality control issues and problems with this knife. They re-released it, and there's still some problems with this knife. But at $54, I don't think you can go wrong, being that Buck has an excellent, excellent customer service and return policy. So if you get a bad one, you can always send it back to them. But you know, great work knife, especially if you get a good one. It locks up solid, no left or right, up or down. You know, it does have, you know, they didn't terminate perfectly down there. And like I said, some minor issues, but the knife is solid, would make a great work knife. That Paul Ball Seat Treated S30V steel would hold an edge for a rather long time. And like I said, at $54, it's kind of hard to beat. That's my first one. And number two is going to be a real steel knife, and that is the H6-1 by Real Steel. Got that beautiful drop point with that nice wedge. This one is coming in right at $48. It's got, see, I think it's on here, 14C28N, great budget steel. Probably one of my favorites in the budget category. Until you step up to like D2 and stuff like that. I'd rather 14C28N over VG10. That's just my preference. Y'all let me know y'all experiences. The 14C28N holds a wicked, wicked sharp edge. I think it was used and still is in razor blades. This is a pretty solid knife. I think it doesn't run on bearings, but it runs on phosphor bronze washers that kind of look like the Chris Reeves washers. They have little slots in them for the grease to catch in. It's a Leon Gang design. Got you. They execute the sharpening chaw pretty nice. Very nice and thin behind the edge. Great slicer. Ergonomics are really, really nice on this knife. It's got that G10 sticker over, I mean, carbon fiber sticker over the G10, but this knife is still light. Supporting a stainless frame lock with their beta lock, where, you know, that's, to me, it's just a gimmick. I don't ever use that. Nice functional pocket clip. Pretty deep carry to right there. You got a lanyard hole. And being that it's a stainless frame lock and it's still super light, it's done that by, look at those nice milled pockets they have. Great, great job. Like the decorative standoffs back there. Just overall, nice knife at the $48 price point. That's number two. Next up is a Steel Wheel Cut Jack in D2 steel at $45. I got my first impressions video of this. I'll be doing a review, so stay tuned for that. But I'm just going to say spoiler alert. If you're on the fence about it, go buy it. Excellent, excellent knife at the price. D2 steel is nice. Nice satin grind. Pretty comfortable ergonomics. I'm not a huge fan of this texture they got on here. It's not, I don't know, it's just not that great. Jimping on here is awesome. Okay, I'm not going to go all the way through this knife because I still got to do the review, but this is the next one in line. $45 steel wheel cut jack D2 steel. All right, Next one is Kershaw, and that is a Kershaw Blur. Gotta have the Kershaw Blur in there. This variant is the Tanto and BDZ1 steel. I don't really have anything to compare that steel with. I've used this to cut down a good bit of boxes and stuff. Nothing major, but it held an edge pretty good. If anybody has any information, the little steel app that I have on my phone doesn't really say a whole lot about it. But love that nice aggressive Tanto. I love how the Tanto kind of sweat with that swedge, it goes down. Excellent point for piercing. You got that secondary edge right there, or a point for piercing. And if you haven't ever had a Blur in your hand, the Blur's ergonomics are just out of this world. Awesome, awesome ergonomics. And this version right here comes in right around $45. Good deal, very good deal. They got tons of different color variations, different steels. You name it, they probably have it. They also have the drop point recurve version. The next is probably one of the best bang for the buck, and that is your Ontario Wrap Model 1 and D2 steel with just your FRN. This is not the one I'm talking about, but the one with the FRN scales runs right around $43. So if you're looking for a good hard use or work knife in a bigger size and you want thumb stud deployment, go Wrap Model 1 D2 steel. If you want a nice lighter EDC flipper, Steel Wheel Cut Jack D2. I mean, this one's $43. This one is $45. So $2 difference. You know, it pretty much is going to boil down to aesthetics and what kind of knife you're looking for. Flipper, non-flipper. There you go. All right. I'll probably do a head-to-head comparison on these two knives later on. And that'll do it for the five picks. I did have an honorable mention in here, but I'll explain why I didn't put it in this lineup. Let's see. Steel Wheel Cut Jack. You can't go wrong with any of these knives, guys. If you're looking for a good budget knife or, you know, trying to stay under the $60 category, none of these can go wrong. You know, you definitely have some good options here. Any questions or concerns, comments, leave them down below for me. I love talking knives, and I love trying to help people out. Like I said, if you want a bigger knife, the Ontario Wrap one. Now, honorable mention that I wanted to add in here, because it's a great slicer and it's a cool knife, is a Real Steel Griffin. And mainly, I already have one Real Steel in here. And being that, you know, if you wanted a plunge lock instead of a frame lock, maybe go here. But this one is $54, but you got aluminum handle scales on this one, and you got the G10 carbon fiber with steel scales on this one. This one's $48. You know, that's just going to depend on your preference. I would choose this one first. This is a more sturdy knife, more comfortable in pocket, and they're both great slicers. You got your full flat here, and you got your almost, you know, flat here. It's all going to be whether you want the plunge lock or frame lock, or yeah, the aesthetics. And you know, this one's running on roller bearings, so it is rather smooth, but this one is also a really smooth knife. This one, in my eyes, let me just make sure before I say this. Now, they both have good ergonomics, but in my eyes, this one with this deeper finger troll right there kind of locks in. You got that nice ramp right there that kind of locks in your hand in this grip. So, ergonomics department, the H6 kind of has a leg up on it, but one thing I am not a huge fan of is that really slight recurve in there. Just, you know, why? Why Real Steel? So if you don't like recurves, here you go. Here's another beauty. They both have that beautiful polished stone wash on there. I'm always looking forward to seeing what Real Steel does. I like their Pro Series knives. They didn't do a great job on the Pro Series of this, but they did a good job on this one and a few of the other ones. I need to get my hands on one of those. So there you go. There's my five budget blades in the 50 and non 50 to $40 category. If y'all like this type of video and y'all want to see more, let me know. I may do a mid-size range or cheaper, all the way down to the cheapest I have. Hope everybody's having an absolute wonderful day. If you hadn't hit that subscribe button yet, hit it now so you don't miss anything. We're always coming out with new stuff, trying to give you all the latest and greatest in the knives, wanting to talk knives. And, you know, this channel is all about positivity. So if you want somebody to bring you up, pick you up, I'm that guy. Hope everybody's enjoying their weekend. I don't know if I'll post this on the weekend, so that might sound stupid. Oh, well, everybody have an absolute wonderful day, and I'll see you next time. Peace.